following is a presentation of ESPN on ABC.
Maybe it's just a game. But maybe it's more than that. In 2019, Layla Anderson was an 11-year-old girl who was sick. As she struggled,
Bangle try there, and that got blocked.
So did her St. Louis Blues, who were in last place in the NHL. But then it happened.
The Blues called, and they want you at the game.
How?
The doctor said it's okay.
No, he didn't. Mommy, no, he didn't.
Maybe it's just a game.
Let's go!
Let's go!
Or maybe a team.
Oh, and a remarkable play by Bennington!
And a young girl needed each other.
Score! The St. Louis Blues are the Stanley Cup champions!
Oh, no.
Maybe it's just a game. Or maybe every game and every moment are worth fighting for. Because maybe it just might be your year. Let's go, Blues!
3 years ago, inspired by Layla Anderson, the St. Louis Blues' historic turnaround culminated in the first Stanley Cup in franchise history. And as this season has progressed, the Blues looking more and more like a team that can win it all again, as are their opponents today, the Minnesota Wild. Welcome everybody inside Enterprise Center in St. Louis in our ABC Hockey Saturday pregame presented by Verizon. A little more than 2 weeks to go till the playoffs. This is a critical game in the Central Division. Minnesota and St. Louis tied for second. Neither one of them is going to catch Colorado. It's unlikely they'll be caught from behind by Nashville or Dallas. So it's quite likely we're looking at a playoff preview of a first round matchup. Hi, everybody. Welcome. Sean McDonough upstairs. Ray Ferraro down at ice level. Delighted to have you with us. Raymond, a very big game for both of these teams here today.
It certainly is. Given the terrific game they played a couple of weeks ago, you got two very similar teams. Maybe more so for Minnesota, though. They haven't won in the last nine times against the St. Louis Blues. They'd sure like to beat them one time before they likely meet in the playoffs in 2 weeks.
And of course, the team that finishes second would have the home ice advantage in a seven-game series. Ray, when we think about these teams, we think of tough, physical, gritty reflections of their head coaches. They are still that, but in both cases, this might be the best team offensively in franchise history, certainly among the best.
Well, I would agree so. I mean, these are two teams historically been built through defense and goaltending, but now they're two of the top six offensive teams in the National Hockey League. The Blues have 720 goal scorers, led by 31 goal scorer Vladdy Tarasenko with 630 goal season the other night. He had 5 points against the Sabres. Robert Thomas is a breakout star. He had 5 assists, leads the Blues with 53 assists on the season. They work together on the same line with Pavel Buchnevich, one of the league's better offensive lines. The Minnesota Wild, on the other hand, are led by a superstar in 24-year-old Kirill the Thrill Kaprizov. Signed a 5-year extension in Minnesota. I don't know that they've had a more dynamic offensive player in their franchise history. He's a game changer. He's a franchise changer. 42 goals, ties for the franchise lead.
He is fun to watch. Minnesota also getting outstanding goaltending since they acquired Marc-Andre Fleury at the trade deadline, part of a very effective duo now with Cam Talbot. With more on their goaltending situation, we'll check in with Emily Kaplan when we come back to St. Louis.
I don't know about you, but I feel good.
Welcome
Welcome to ABC Hockey Saturday, presented by Expedia. Chris Chelios, Mark Messier, John Butchergoss, and David Perron joins us now from the ice during warm-ups. David, you're having a great year, man. The highest goal per game rate of your career. You might hit 30 for the first time. Scoring in the league is up as well. Any reason why scoring seems to be up this year in the NHL? The winner gets 100 points. They both have 98. Who is starting for the Wild? Marcus Foligno in the dressing room announcing the starting lineups for Minnesota.
There we go. We got Freddy!
Don't forget the goalie.
Don't forget the goalie, most important
player. Do you guys do that back in your day?
That's the best. That's like a scene out of Dodgeball. That's pretty good.
We will rock you in the background. Yeah. Never did that mess in the Edmonton or Ranger
days?
We had
the starting lineups like that, too. Not quite as theatrical as that, but we had it going.
This is the one playoff matchup we know we're going to get. I think we're going to end for a good one, rock'em sock'em hockey game.
I think this is a great matchup, intriguing matchup. Both teams play very similar games there, so it's going to be interesting to see what happens.
Let's get to it. Sean McDonough, Ray Ferraro, Emily Kaplan with the call. Sean.
All right, Bucci, gentlemen, thank you. And welcome back inside Enterprise Center in St. Louis. The Blues and the Wild for the third and final time of the regular season. St. Louis has won the first two meetings. It'll be Ville Husso in goal at age 27. He's become the number one netminder for the first time in his career. Fifth in the NHL in goals against and save percentage. And Cam Talbot, part of that outstanding duo now with Marc-Andre Fleury. They've been alternating since the Flower joined the Wild. Talbot is 10-0-2 in his last 12 starts, an all-star for the first time this year at age 34. Starting goaltenders were brought to you by Honda. There's Marc-Andre Fleury. Dean Evason, the Wild coach, says he still hasn't decided if they'll continue to alternate or at some point one of them might start two in a row, but at this point it's not broken, so he's not going to fix it. Ready for the opening faceoff. Minnesota and the visiting white controlled the draw. And we're underway. Delighted to have you with us on our ABC Hockey Saturday. Line combinations, defense pairings brought to you by Taco Bell.